And we're back. So let's see. We're gonna do an end turn here. And then we'll go from there. I think the refugee camp at this point is kind of more important than the enchanter's hall thingamajigger. Oh, but I do need to recruit this week. Fuck, okay. There we go. You just need to pick up whatever. Find it empty. Eh, whatever. I'm still very paranoid about not actually having pressed the record button because I did that once. Oh boy, was I pissed. Almost went an entire hour playing with no saves between parts, and it wasn't recording. Let's see. Yeah, end turn. Okay. Let's do that. Might actually have to dismiss this guy. I don't think I have enough room for moving artifacts and stuff. I kind of want a scouting hero over here too on this island, so I might have to dismiss Malcolm. Malcolm the Sailing Princess. Yeah. Quite. How droll. Malcolm the Sailing Princess is going to do what exactly? Well, Solmir is going to move first. I am not dismissing Solmir, I can tell you that much. By the way, no, doesn't have the artifacts. And we're gonna attack into manufacturing. Ouchies! Yes, quite. Okay, I don't really need to hurry to finish this round, so I'm just gonna take my time. Zappity zap zap. And just let them move. That's fine. Sure. I will kill you. There we go. I will kill you. Actually, I can do it this round, so I will just cast Resurrect. You are zapped, sir. Madam, actually. Beg your pardon. Zappity zap zap. Nice. And plus one knowledge. And what do we get here? Another chance at Town Portal and Resurrection and Chain Lightning. That's nice. Forgetfulness. That's very nice. Wow. I don't think it works against Faerie Dragons, though. Because if it did, holy shit, would that be good. Ranged attack only. I don't think it works on casters, does it? Anyone in chat have any fucking clue? Let's see. Everything else I think I already had. Lookout Tower, Cloud Temple, and Castle. I'll build a cloud temple here. Kind of redundant, but sure. Let's see, so we have forgetfulness. Causes all enemy troops to forget to use their ranged attack in combat. Would it work on Faerie Dragons with their magic attack? That is what I need to know. Very curious about that. Oh, also, do we have an artifact merchant? No, we don't. That's fine. Okay, I think Malcolm, sadly, you are going to just, you know, bite the dust here. Oh, we have a black market over here. Cool. Oh, and I can upgrade some. No, I can't because blah. I could double back to one of my other cities and upgrade. I could do that. Or I could just buy some magi and upgrade those. Which is what I think I'm going to be doing. There we go. I'm gonna recruit you. And I'm gonna recruit you. Very nice. I don't think I'm... Well, I'm not gonna say it. it's just gonna, you know, attract misfortune if I do say it. Hopefully there's nothing too groundbreakingly awesome on the water somewhere. But yeah, I think we're gonna be dismissing Malcolm. Sadly. There we go. Goodbye, Malcolm. And we are going to be putting you in here. We are going to Nila or Sorsha. Well, we're gonna recruit Nila because we get some free units out of it. Okay. Well, yeah, competitively free. Since we're gonna have to spend the money anyway. Okay, there we go. So that's the portal that we need to go through. And this is my hero. There are many like him, but this one is mine. I never actually watched that movie from start to finish. Okay, so 133. Can I actually kill them? Oddly enough, yes, I can. That's about... Well, I don't really want to take the chance. It might be not enough on a very bad roll. But now it's going to definitely be enough if I get a chance to attack. There we go, and zap. No use taking chances when you don't have to, right? Oh, we have another type, another bowstring of Unicorn's Mane, but we can have some magic arrows. Cart of Lumber. Oh, who cares? That's fine. Okay, we already have one of the bowstrings. We just need to figure out a way to fucking get hit. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Ooh, Cloud Temple. Delicious. Yes. Nice. Oh. Sexy. Okay. There you go. Yes, I would. Thank you for asking. It's very polite. So, we have 4 titans per week on every dwelling that is capable of producing them. Yes, yes. Oh, what the fuck. Okay, this is gonna hurt. Ooh! Spell power 20. I'd pay well for his story. Ogre's Club of Havoc. Well, thank you very much, sir. Apparently, there is still no sign of that Collar of Conjuring. But Ogre's Club of Havoc is useful, so we're gonna put that in. Oh, I should have... Oh, Nicholas... Ah, balls. Too late now. And, let's see. Definitely fuck you. yeah. Wow, that's gonna be a good boost. We have that. I really don't like morale procs. I don't like anything that involves an element of a chance, so we're gonna keep that in. I go through here. What the? Oh, balls. Yeah. Attack rates. Yeah, sure, whatever. Oh. No. And go through here. Yes. Now, guess how many of these are gonna be? Matan says, after a quick search, didn't find anything about forgetfulness affecting spells, but at least the expert version is mass forgetfulness. Yes. It would be very nice if it would make them forget their ranged attack in the form of a spell, which it is, but... So let's see how many Nagas are going to be there. 3k Naga Queens. About probably going to be 3.5k, the same as we fought last time. So you're going to notice that I'm not particularly threatened by them now, because... Well, A, we have an actual army now. Last time we fought them with, what was it, 70? 70 enchanters? And a couple of hundred gremlins? And we still won? So, not too threatened by it now. yes, overconfidence shall be my downfall. It probably will. Let's face it. I'm gonna get myself fucked. I need to get the Bowstring of the Unicorns main. I need to get some extra units before I get, you know, through here. But there's probably, you know what? I don't want to. I have enough time to get through here, scout the area a little bit, go back, get some extra units just in case. 100 Faerie Dragons. Yeah, that's going to hurt a lot. I think we can handle it. I think we can handle it, but that's going to hurt a lot. Okay. 3K Nagas. Here goes. Yeah, exactly the same thing, except it's Naga Queens instead of regular Nagas, like it was last time. We're gonna start off the same way we started last time, I would say, with a mass slow, because that's gonna buy us a shit ton of time. Not as much against Naga Queens as it did against Nagas, and they are on native terrain as well, but it's still going to buy us a shit ton of time. See, 4. It's gonna basically double the amount of time it requires them to get here. Okay. And then I'm gonna wait for them to actually, you know, get a little bit closer into range. Nice, we have a bless. Okay. And then we are going to murder them. We are going to murder the fuck out of them. We might have to resurrect some creatures, we might have to cast a few clone spells, but all in all, I expect this to be a slaughter. Yes, there we go. 3.7k damage, that is definitely not enough, so you're not gonna get in there, sir. But you, well, you. You know what, that's almost enough, but not, so we're not gonna do it. I mean, if I would throw my gargoyles in there, but I'm gonna save them for something more. I'm gonna save them for something more. Zap. Okay, Master Genies. Actually, I can do, I can kill them. I can kill this stack with a hit and run. I should have maybe... No, I couldn't have, because the giants go after. Okay, I can do a few blinds, I would say. That would secure our situation, or we can just jump straight through the clones, to the clones. If we do the enchanters, I would say they do the most amount of ranged damage, so we can do... Yeah, I would think the enchanters, cloning the enchanters would be the best idea right now. Yes, sir, let's do an enchanter clone. You're gonna wait, you're gonna wait. You're gonna wait, you're gonna wait. You're actually going to wait as well. Actually, you know what? Fuck that. Zap you. And you're gonna wait because I wanna zap one of the other stacks to get more damage done. And you're gonna wait too. There we go. Interesting, yeah. See, I knew that because I left that stack alive, these two will be confused. Now if I kill her, they're gonna try to come in afterwards. I'm gonna waste some damage on it, but she's gonna be able to reach me next turn anyway. Unless I wanna save killing her for the genius. Yes, I will. So I'm gonna attack this stack instead. I'm gonna have to kill that stack with something, because otherwise it's gonna get to me. There we go. I wanna either kill it with this guy or kill it with the Titans. I think I'm not gonna chance it. I'm just gonna kill it with you. Defend. Genies. First of all, I need to check four, right? One, two. Wait. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. So yeah, they're not gonna reach if I do this, and I can do a hit and run anyway. So, and bolt to the face. Okay. I can do some more clones if I really want to. At this point, it doesn't really look like I'll need to, honestly. Do I want to be greedy and save some more mana? Kind of, yeah. Because I don't know what is going to happen, like scripted ambushes along the way and whatnot, after this point. So I will just wait for now and we'll see if I need to, depending on how they move. I'll get a better feel for the situation. You though, you know, you can just die. and you too. There we go. Wait. It's too bad I can't get the XP, but... Okay, and that's pretty good. Not enough, sadly, for the 21 giants to hop into the battle. Defend. The genies are going to be able to finish off this stack. And... Lightning bolt. Ooh, wait. Nice. Okay. Sure. Wait in case the other stacks gets into range. You're not gonna get into range, so just fire now. Maybe I should have just tried to soften up that stack though with the gremlins. Yeah. Sounds like that would have been a better idea. I kind of think I'll have enough. Should have enough. Let's see what happens. Yeah, there we go. And zap. Not enough right now, but maybe after a few rounds of throwing lightning bolts into their faces. There we go. And slow and clone, pretty much. Give me some gold. Okay. Neela. I think I'm going to dismiss Neela in the end. And, but not right now. Not yet. Let's check if I have anything to, that I need to build. A castle, definitely. Yes, more unit. Production, and I'm going to want to build the lookout tower as well, right there. Nothing here. Artifact merchants. Okay. Okay. Move. Yes, you do. There, you're fine, you need to move. The color of conjuring has made no appearances as of yet, so that's kind of weird. Would have thought it would be on the map somewhere if it was part of a quest. Either that or it would be something that I would be able to import from the Rust Dragon thing. In which case, yeah, didn't do that first, I did this first. I'm gonna grab this thingy, and then I think I'm gonna dismiss Neela. Or maybe I should send that in first. No, because this guy has town portal, so he can come back. The Neela can't. I would dismiss her anyway, but all by the power of your forces, blah de blah de blah. After the disorienting feeling of the teleporter wears off, you start down the path. You come across a leprechaun sitting on what looks to be a very old stump. "Hello again," says the leprechaun with a grin on his face. "Hello," you say, said wondering why he isn't mad that you tried to take his head off with your bare hands. All of your wandering ceases when you see the leprechaun shimmer and fade away. Big surprise. Where once one leprechaun sat, now three sets of fairy dragons sit. That's a lot of fairy dragons to fit into one leprechaun. Realizing this dragon has been playing with you all along, all of this time, you look for the fairy dragons, wondering which is the real one. Oh, interesting. So the story is that all of these fairy dragons are actually illusions cast by one single very powerful fairy dragon. Well, that's kind of cool. So we have 100, 100, 100. I'm gonna have to fight all of them. So I have 4 weeks at my disposal. I don't really know. I'm gonna actually scout the edges here. Just as you're about to attack the dragon, you think you hear the leprechaun's voice and you hear, "Are you sure it's is the right one?" Then I'm gonna go here. Haha, this isn't the right one either. Hey, what are you doing? This isn't the right one. Okay, so that is probably the one that I'm supposed to attack, the one on the far left. I have enough time to, you know, bolster my forces a little bit more, though, which I will take the time to do. Day six. I'm still hoping maybe in one of these camps, these mercenary camps, refugee camps, rather, I will have the opportunity to get something faster than the fairy dragons and get the speed advantage. Maybe. I mean, I'm not too stressed about it because of the fact that I now know how big the stacks are, and I know that I have enough army to handle it. But it would be, it would make for a very, very much more easier of an engagement. I'm gonna dismiss Neela though, sadly, because her purpose is done. Let's read her story. Neela is one of the strongest of her kind, being able to resist an incredible amount of punishment. She's into BDSM. She somehow is able to instill this resistance in the troops she commands. Because they also do... Dismiss. Nah, I don't really care about obsidian gargoyles. Okay. So you're fine. I'm gonna port you over to Silver Spire and get those artifacts, first of all. Silver Spire. Lovely. But in order to do that, the person in Silver Spire needs to actually come out, which is you. You, fine sir. Quite. Verily. Okay. Luck and morale. That would be useful if I had anything that wouldn't be an angel as my speed unit, because it would counterbalance the negative morale. Be boasting of the unicorn's mane. Okay, we're going to replace that, and that's going to be a huge boon. And I'm going to hold on to this one. I'm probably going to equip it instead of the gloves, if I remember. And that's going to give the gremlins a little bit of extra staying power. Just a little bit, like 25% extra health points for them. And I need a first aid tent. That would be cool. Okay. You're going to stay here like so. Let's see, what can I recruit from here? I can recruit some more gremlins, since I'm here. I can recruit some of these and upgrade them. Very nice, very nice. And maybe some master genies. Well, not that many, but a few. Okay. Let's just, since it's not as close as I thought it was going to be, let's double check that I have everything that I need to have. Is it in? Yeah, but more importantly, structures like this one. Yeah. Let's see. Refugee camp. I should probably try and free that refugee camp. See if there's nothing. You know, have more chances of getting that unit that I want. And I can stop by the war machine factory on the way, too. No point in visiting this, already at max level for this map. Already visited that, and that, and that, and this right here, and this right here, and this, and every town basically on the way. Let's see, other stat enhancing structures that I could have missed. This one, no. Okay. We have some giants here that we could recruit, or rather press into service, because they're already recruited or whatever. Visited, no sense going there, already have all these skill slots filled. Visited, visited, nice, two stacks of cogs right next to each other. If I still had any interest in farming XP, that would be a nice place to go. Sadly, the injuries were here and I wasted them. Still regret that. Visited. Visited. Looks like I got everything on the map so far, at least. Yeah, okay. And the fairy dragons right there. Okay, looking good. Looking good. So, I'm gonna make my way towards the refugee camp over there. Try to free it up, see if I can get a lucky unit or two or whatever for getting that speed advantage. I should have been looking for that since the start of the map, honestly. Like, should be a priority actually for when you're playing tower to get a unit that isn't tower that could grant you that speed advantage, I would say. I'll try to keep an eye out for that from now on. He might actually be able to make it there this week, though I would be surprised. Nope. Too bad, you know, there were some Arc Devils right there, but making time, oh well. Oh my. Losing my voice entirely. So, let's check. Artifact Merchants, no. Okay, the Cloud Temple, no. Everything built. Everything I really care about, yes. There would be an order, a specific order in which I need to do these things to upgrade, to bring units if I could bring them all, but I won't be able to bring them all, so it doesn't really matter that much. I'll still have to observe a little bit of ordering and discipline, and also I think I will have... I have to look into if the... trading post? Wait a minute, where was the trading post? I think it was... There's one there. I don't think I can really make it there safely. I'll probably just use the marketplace values. I don't remember how... Completely losing my voice here. I don't remember exactly how many marketplaces worth is a trading post in ratio advantage. Actually, you know what? Let's look. Whoops, muted myself. So I'm gonna look it up. I'm gonna look up what the trading post is actually worth. resource trading advantage, because I'm gonna spend all my resources on gold except for the gems. Of course, the player has six or more marketplaces, the rate in a trading post is actually worse than in a town with marketplace. Okay, let's go back to the screen, get rid of this UI element. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so I have enough to trade at a marketplace, and that should be enough. Which actually reminds me, I should be doing that right now. So I will. I don't really need any more ore, I don't really need any more wood, and if I do, I can actually produce enough. I don't need any more mercury. I don't need any more crystals. And if I do, I can produce enough. Gonna need a lot of gems though, so let's start from the top, shall we? Upgrade and recruit. Okay, and there we go. And actually, we're gonna get some of those, and we're gonna get some of these. Then we're gonna get some of these. We're gonna grab some of these. Looking good so far. I have a lot of towns to recruit from now. So, yeah, I'm still very regretful of the thing that I keep mentioning. Because I'm gonna have to take losses on that first strike from the Faerie Dragons, and I could have avoided that, you know, with not being a dumbass. I'm not gonna have enough money to upgrade everything if I keep doing this, so. Good thing I ran out of creatures to recruit. Okay. So, yeah, that should be good. I'll collect them all in one place, and then I'll see about the upgrades. Where do I have... Here I have all these structures to upgrade. So I should collect them here, and then I'll bring them over here, and then rest one day to have full mana, just in case I need it. And like that. I am losing my voice hardcore, so we should finish this map soon. Damn. Okay, all dwellings increase in population. And... no. And... Praise baby Jesus, as always. Okay, let's make room for that guy. We'll fit him in between the Titans and the Giants. I'll probably, after I upgrade the Giants, I'm gonna have room for. Yeah. And now we have the speed advantage. And now, it's not that we won't take losses in the fight against the Faerie Dragons, but we'll get the opportunity to deal the damage to them first, which will severely limit the amount of damage that they deal to us when they get to attack, and it means I'm gonna have to spend less mana for each engagement by a lot. A lot! Which is very helpful. Okay, one Archangel. Yep. Happy. Cool. Okay, we had one more refugee camp that we're not gonna need to check necessarily right now. The fun thing about Archangels is that they also negate their own morale penalty for being, you know, an extra unit, an extra unit type, see? So, minus one temporary until next battle. Oh, okay. But anyway, troops of three alignments, minus one, Archangel in group, plus one, because the enchanters are neutral. So they don't count as, tower units, which is kind of a shame, but don't look a gift horse in the mouth, as they say. So I'm gonna port over to Ayer. While I completely lose my voice entirely, I'm gonna go to okay, you can stay here. I'm gonna bring you. I'm going to bring you. Actually, no. Beautiful, you're gonna stay. Okay. I'm gonna go and get all of the non-upgraded units and the upgraded units and whatever the fuck, and I'm gonna bring them over, okay? I don't know if I have enough slots though for all that shit. Unless I start upgrading Magi on the fly. You know what, I'll just do that. Okay. Okay. Let's see. Plus two. I'll try to bring these two, but it's gonna take a while. Yeah, okay. Genies. Six genies is nothing to be laughed at, you know. I would bring the Titans too, but really, you know what, I'm recruiting these guys more out of inertia than anything. I don't think I'm gonna be able to make it to any civilized areas with this army that I have here. By the time that I want to go with it, at least. I'm gonna try to bring Fafnir over for some extra enchanters. And you can actually get your ass over here. There we go. I'm actually gonna leave this one for last so I can... Actually, should I start now or should I wait for the other guys to actually reach?
with their stuff. Excuse me. I think I'll grab the units from manufactory at least. Yes, quite, because there's nobody on their way over there. It's gonna be the town I have to end up in anyway, but it's not gonna be the town I'm gonna be upgrading much of anything in. So, yeah. There we go. Some unupgraded lovely genie ladies. There we go. I'll trade some more resources too. I'm gonna keep the gems for now. I'm probably gonna be able to trade some of the gems, but I'm gonna keep them for now because I don't know exactly how many I need yet until I recruit all of the titans, giants and whatnot. Okay, so which other town is pretty much safe? That one is actually safe, but I'm not gonna put it. This one has someone heading towards it. This one has someone heading towards it. This one has someone heading towards it. And this one has someone heading towards it. So I'm gonna stay in here for the time. No, wait a minute. I can. I will go to. Which one is likely to get there first? She is. Okay, so I'm gonna go to the main town. The first town I ever had, Corona. Corona, Silver Spire, Machina, Silver Wing, IR, and Manufacturing. Interesting set of town names, if I do say so. I'm gonna end the turn for now. Okay. Gunnar, fast as always. Grab that on your way, why don't you? There we go. Solmir. Okay, you're just gonna basically sit here. Cool. Let's see, what can we recruit here? We're gonna recruit this, we're gonna recruit this, we're gonna grab some of this. Not in a sexual way, because we can grab that. yes, quite. Can grab the lady genies in sexual ways too, but that would be sexual harassment at their workplace. Not so much joking, but it's funny. Let's see, 414. Yeah, that's a lot. How much would it cost to upgrade these guys? Oh, a lot of money. Do I have enough for half at least? Yeah, I would almost have enough for all of them. I don't think I'm gonna be able to upgrade all of the giants, honestly. But I'll be able to upgrade the enchanters. I'll try to upgrade the genies. And I'll probably keep the giants as a melee stack. It's apparently they're good as is too. So they might be able to do something. On the other hand, bringing the magi unupgraded, that would just suck. Because they would just get... They would get slaughtered. I mean, though, it's not the worst idea in the world. They would get slaughtered, though. They would get murdered in the face. And I don't really want to have the extra slot filled. Okay. So you are waiting for one more turn for the lovely lady here to make her way to you. There we go. Let's see, who is going to make it to their respective town? You are going to make it to your respective town, so I'm probably gonna visit this thing next. Oh, nice, we have some stuff in there. Mm-hmm. You're just sitting there, you're gonna make it. Except you shouldn't have. You know what? You can have these. You can have these. There we go, Gunnar. You deserve it, buddy. Oh, actually, let's just have you leave all of the obsidian gargoyles. Okay, and you're just gonna have a whole bunch of... Oh, wait a minute. I wanted to split them evenly, not into stacks of one. There we go. Shift. Shift click. At least in the HD mod. Okay, Solmir. Almost there. That's decent. Okay. And you, not nearly. So we're gonna go to Machina next. Machina. Let's see. Nice. Then we're gonna go to, what is this, Silver Spire? Silver Spire. There we go. Have a lot of gold, that's nice. Having a lot of gold when you need a lot of gold is always nice. Wow, that's a lot of giants. If I could morph them all into titans, that would be kick-ass, but I don't really need to either, so... Okay, gold. Gold! Imagine I'm Jesse Cox and doing the old prospector voice from Terraria. From their Terraria series. I mean, Jesse Cox and Total Biscuit doing Terraria. That was fun. Okay, so that is going to be the end point. I'm going to probably go to Silverwing and wait, or just grab the units myself. So I'm going to go to... Is there anything I need to grab from the artifact merchant? Curse, knowledge plus 3, or the thingy, the cloak of thingamabob. I could use a cloak, but not that one. No, I don't think so. How much is it on my helm for, right? Yeah, cool. Okay. So we're going to Silverwing. Silverwing. And we have these units. So many units. Nice. Okay. And I'm just gonna grab it, grab the extra units from you manually, and we're gonna go to Ayer. Now I would you know, wait or something, but we don't actually need to. I think we have enough army to make this. Oh shit. Well, you know what? I can still go over there. So let's see. Town portal to Silver Spire. I forgot to trade with Solmir. But that's fine. There we go. All fixed. Back to Ayer now. Have enough movement points and have more than enough mana. You're fine. You're gonna go back. You're gonna go back, actually. You are also going to go back. And you are going to go back as well. Now, what can we upgrade? Good question. I want all of the gremlins, first of all. I'm going to put you in here. We have enchanters. You're going to be in there. There we go. There we go. There we go. And so. So how much to upgrade all of the genies? I actually like the genies now. I used to not be a fan of them, but they're fast. At, you know, for the level 5 creature, they're pretty good, I would say. That Terraria series was totally awesome, says Matan. Yeah, it was, it was. I really loved playing Terraria too, but I've kind of done all that I wanted to do in Terraria. I'm not gonna get into Terraria and Starbound, but I don't really like Starbound that much. Not specifically because it's a bad game necessarily, but because so many people just said, "Oh, it's a Terraria killer," or "What the fuck you." Anyway, so many titans I'm not gonna be able to afford. Otherwise though, I've recruited everything from every other town. So that's cool. Right? Yeah. Nice. Sweet. So in order to upgrade these guys, I'm gonna split one off And we're gonna see exactly how much I need to upgrade. I need 400 per. Okay, I need 400 per. That means I would need about 92k or so, give or take. You know, 94.4, if we're to be exact. Yeah, I could bring them along as, instead of the gargoyles, as a, you know, regular stack. It would work. On the other hand, let's see, so we need 2 gems per for the Titans. We are producing gems at a rate of, how much is that? 3 per? I think it's times 1, yeah, it's 3 per turn, so that's not too much. I mean, if I start selling my gems, I won't be able to have enough gems to make them back in time. So 90, that's 2, plus 11, so that's, let's say an even number, 100, that's 200 gems I'm gonna need to have all of the Titans possible. Let's say 210 for a little bit of a margin. I'm not comfortable with selling any of my gems. I could sell 100 and something, but how much would that even give me? It wouldn't give me that much. No. So 90, 108, 4, 4, yeah. Speed 5. Yeah, the problem is they're kind of slow too. That's a problem. Yeah, that's a problem right there, you see. Because if they were enchanters, they would be faster, obviously, and they could just do the damage before anyone else, but... Do I want to wait one more turn? How much do I make per turn? I make 20k. That would give me some extra options, surely. But I'm not going to be able to change them all anyway, so I'm not going to be able to recruit all of the Titans either. I'm going to be able to get only 4 of them, and then we're going to, I think we're going to go as is. I'm going to bring them along as a normal stack. We're going to leave the Obsidian Gargoyles behind for now. I'm gonna use the extra money that I get from the next turn to upgrade as many of the magi as possible into enchanters. But yeah, that's gonna be it. Okay, so that's what we're doing. We're going to go to a manufactory though, and we're gonna rest there to grab our spell points to full before we head into combat. We're gonna see how bad, how tough of a battle we have here. I think I'm gonna engage them all though, honestly. Just for funsies. And if we have to, we'll retreat for mana. Okay, remember not to let the Archangel die. At least not until, not between battles, because he's probably gonna die after the first turn, but I'm gonna have enough time to cast what I need to cast. So yeah, there's that. Okay. End turn for now. Yes. Let's move these people in position just in case I need some extra reinforcements. And again, I kind of want to keep practicing this supply stuff so I don't accidentally forget to do it like I sometimes do. Because when it actually counts, it would be a problem if I would forget. Okay, so we are gonna split off this thing into that many. No. Whoops. Not upgrade there, upgrade here. It's a different thing. There we go. Upgrade to enchanters. 400 per. Yeah, 1, 2, 3. About that many. Maybe one more. Yeah, one more. There we go. And thusly, we've spent all of our money as wisely as we could have possibly done so. Now for troop positioning. Do I want to keep these guys bunched up like that? I'm not entirely sure, but if I move these guys over there, they're going to be bunched up with the ammo cart anyway. These guys are going to be bunched up with the first aid tent I don't have. I forgot to get it. Fuck. But yeah, we'll deal with that. That's more of a decoy rather than anything else. Okay. We're gonna go in. Actually, I'm gonna move you here. I'm gonna keep you there. Yeah. Okay. Let's see. So. Save, even though I don't really want to load saves. Grumble, grumble. Okay. Go through here. I'm gonna start. This one is the right one, as we remember, but I want to fight them all. So we're gonna do that. And anything else I need to switch in? Luck. Morale, I don't want them to have morale. Under any circumstances, no morale for them. So I'm gonna keep the spirit of oppression in there. And let's see. A throng. Let's do a visions just in case they multiplied or something. 100, 100, 100, and that's the correct stack length, the left one. So 33, 34, 33. Okay. Now, what would be the best spell to cast to secure that advantage I was so adamant about having? Either haste or prayer would be a good choice, but 10. Haste would give them 15. It's plus 5, so they might go first. Prayer would let them hit harder. But haste or slow, I don't know what the factor of slow is. Would it reduce them? We're gonna try that. So it's 15 normally and now it's 7, so it's kind of half, so it's 7. That's good. That's actually pretty good. Yeah, I like that. Okay, I'm gonna move the Archangels a little bit forward just so they don't get bunched up with this stack. They're not gonna be doing much of anything anyway, so. What? Oh, I have a thing, plus minus one morale until next battle. I forgot to get rid of that. Oh well. Not nice. Okay. So yeah, that's pretty bad. 17k. I can demolish one of these stacks though. 17k. It's probably rounded up, so I'm gonna do one of the 33 stacks. I'm gonna do you. There we go. Also, haste would have let me attack with the giants, so that would have been maybe nicer. I'm gonna have to wait now. Yeah, and the titans had a bad morale thingy, so that was bad. Oh well, live and learn. We're still gonna get out of this pretty well, trust me. Okay, pretty well off. Wow, that was a lot of damage. And I might even consider attacking with the archangels. 155 damage. That's all of the work of the attack skill. 61 attack skill versus 20 defense. Basically, yeah, it's kind of a straight up math. 60 divided by 20 is 3 times the damage. So about that sounds about, yeah, that's about it. Okay. We're next turn, so you know what? I'm actually gonna blind you. Oh, interesting. Offensive spellcaster. What was that though? What was that? Wait. Okay, and you're just dead, son. There we go. I'm not going to be attacking, but I'm going to move my titans. I'm going to move my titans. I don't want to have them closely bunched up or anything. That's kind of what I'm going for here. No frost rings hitting several targets. Nothing like that. Nope. Let's see. Defend. Defend. And he can cast Resurrect, which is cool. So let's see, who can I cast Resurrect on that would, you know, make a significant difference? I'll cast it on the... basically, I can only resurrect the Master Gremlins with that many Archangels. I'm curious, does this guy have some sort of magic protection now, or what? I don't know what that deflections thing was about. Was it maybe some terrain function, or... A hidden passive that I'm not aware of for Faerie Dragons, or maybe something I'm wearing that is backfiring on me. Weird. Okay. Either way, we're gonna do some resurrections now. We are gonna do some lovely, lovely resurrections. 88. We had 90. Well. Wait and resurrect. It's the wait and resurrect game, kids. Isn't this exciting? I'm not gonna cut this part though. We're kind of gonna go over an hour, but c'est la vie. 282. That seems like I have less spell power for some reason. I usually resurrect 350. Oh, because of the ring. Ah, yes, I see. They have more health points, so I resurrect less of them. But they also die less, so that's good. There we go. Defend, defend. Stone skin. Delicious. Okay. 22. I might have gotten them all, but I'm gonna wait anyway. It's safer, and there's no use in rushing. Let's see. Oh, nope. And 124. Okay, that's all. Defend, and if you will, please do the honors. Zap. Done. 50k XP. I used up about 100 spell points, so I think I can do another one of these before I go back home to rest a little bit. 25, 25, 25. Interesting split this time. We're not going to have negative morale problems now, so we're going to do the exact same strategy, I would say. We're going to do a little bit of a... Oh, wait a minute. Last time we determined that I could have been able to attack with the giants if I would have cast maybe... haste, but no, they don't get to go before. It's plus five. It's plus five. But I'm gonna do a slow. Or should I do a slow and then a haste, or should I just try the haste? I think we're gonna try different things. We're gonna try the haste this time. I know it's plus five, so yeah, they're not gonna be faster. See, tied. Yeah, it's not as good of an option as a slow, sadly. I'm gonna move you forward a little bit, and you are actually going to go over there and murder the fuckers in the face, like so. There we go. Oh, and I should try forgetfulness. I should try forgetfulness before I forget. I'm hilarious. Not gonna be able to kill an entire stack. How far can you go? I'll attack. You. Yeah. Fuck you. Okay, and you are dead. Ow! I'm gonna spend so much mana on resurrections now. Fuck you. 13. Kind of a risk, really, but they're already gonna have to be resurrected, so. And... meh, 29 damage. And you're dead. I'm gonna try forgetfulness next turn. Let me just remember not to kill the fairy dragons. Oh, wait a minute. If I try forgetfulness, they're gonna go into melee and they're gonna get themselves killed. Not a good option. I'm gonna try it eventually. I'm gonna try it maybe on the last stack. Gonna have some fun with the last stack. Okay, okay. Let's do a resurrection on the gremlins and... Gremlins? Goblins? What the fuck are they? Gremlins. Okay. Sure. And we're gonna do a shit ton of resurrections because that's what we need to do. Good thing the ammo card didn't die, but it did take some severe damage. Close. It was close. Another ammo card almost bit the dust. Defend, 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 defend. Okay, resurrection. Oh, I was worried I had accidentally done something that I shouldn't have. Okay, resurrected. One titan, because he's a titan. He's a motherfucking titan and he's tough. By the way, how much defense? 55. Well, yes, quite. Defend, defend, defend. Okay, and time for the gremlins, I would suppose. Yes. Let's see. Still not at max. Yes. I always get worried that I accidentally cast something to kill the dragons before resurrecting everyone when the enchanter's cast. Okay. And that's all of them. If I really, really wanted to... I don't really know. Because if I chance it like that, I could dispel the blind, cast... forgetfulness, try it out, but they could do a chain lightning or something on several targets, and then I'll have to spend more mana resurrecting several stacks, which would be bad. I might make myself go over. I don't want to do that. We're going to try it on the last set of dragons. Let's see if I have enough for a town portal. If so, we're going to go back to manufacturing. Movement points is the problem. Yes, okay, good. So we're going to rest here. We're gonna rest here and recuperate before the final battle. Do I really need to move these guys? Not really. Okay, sure, whatever. Nope. Okay. The final battle. Final battle. Okay, so let's see. Armageddon's Blade. Campaign 1. Campaign 2, scenario 2. Winning. There we go. In case I want to get back to it at some point. And we're going to go through and... I would have liked to upgrade some more of the enchanters. But that's not. I don't have enough room to split the stacks, that's the only problem. Can I? No. It would be about, what, 4k? I would be able to upgrade half of them. Fuck it. Okay. And we're gonna attack the throng of fairy dragons. 50 and 50, interesting split. And, we're gonna go with prayer, I would think. No, we're gonna go with slow. This time around, we're gonna go with slow. Okay, and I'm gonna try to use forgetfulness in some capacity. Yeah, I can move you forward a little bit. How far can you... Oh, you can attack... I shouldn't have moved you there. 50k. Yeah, you can do some severe damage to that stack, so yeah, sure, why not? I'll do it. 10. Acceptable losses. I will zap you in the face, sir. And you as well. Nice. Sweet, as they say. Ouch. That hurt. Not much, but it hurt. Kind of. A little bit, maybe. That would be enough to kill them, but I wanna try the forgetfulness thing. So I'm gonna do forgetfulness. Oh, that spell will affect me. Okay, so it doesn't work. Okay, we know that then. So we're gonna do a lovely round of blind and resurrect. Quite. Oh fuck, they resisted it. Interesting. I wasn't aware they could do that. Gonna do a resurrect with the archangels then. And I'm gonna move the genies back so they don't accidentally kill someone. They're not supposed to. Defend. 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 Yeah, yeah, fuck off. Defend. And blind, come on. Interesting. I didn't realize they had that kind of a spell defense thing going on. I don't know what that's about. So, lovely round of resurrects for everyone. Yeah, just the genies and the... interesting that 10 of those could only kill 4 genies. Eh, got this guy really good. Got this. He started off so bad. I was complaining all the time about his stats, but now he just, because I collected all of the scholars as +2 stats instead of plus skills, and because I collected all of the map structures for +2 primary abilities, got him really good. Got him really good. Some really good stats. Which are awesome. I can only imagine that they'll get more awesome in the next scenario with the Rust Dragons before we get to the Azure Dragons, which honestly, I still think they are going to figure out some way to make the Azure Dragons kick my ass, even though the and we're going to have the Titans deliver the last blow in this scenario, melee. Even though his stats are so good, Azure Dragons are super good stats themselves. And depending on how many they stack, still enough opportunity to fuck me over. Let's see. Okay, we're gonna cast a prayer instead, just for funsies. I would say. Whoa! Defend. Defend, and you're gonna get into melee, and you're gonna fuck these bitches up. Ah, cast weakness. Not very important, but thank you. And wait, and wait, and gentlemen, with this, we end the menace of the fairy dragons. Boom. Fuck off. There we go. Congratulations, you have completed your quest to kill the fearsome beast and can claim victory. It was interesting that they had so many stacks of fairy dragons, but the narrative seems to be that it was one fairy dragon casting a whole bunch of illusions, so he was an incredibly powerful spellcaster. And those all were just illusions that he was casting to attack you. Very interesting. Very interesting. I'm gonna be interested in the other scenarios too. It's definitely turning out better than I thought it would. Okay. So we have end of campaign 2, scenario 2. Not winning, we actually won. And that's that. Let's see what's in the next one. Matan says GG, indeed. GG. So Rust Dragons is the next one. And I lost all my voice. All my voice has been lost. God damn. Where is it? I'm going to have to find it before next week. I'm going to need a metal detector in this place. And we're going to have to comb the countryside for my voice. Oh, fuck. Rust dragons have invaded the area, halting mine production. Flag all of the mines within 6 months, but do not lose the dragon slayer or your cause will be lost. Recon his skills, spells, and experience up to level 24 will carry over to the next scenario. I don't think he's going to import the army as he did from the first scenario to the second scenario. But we are doing well with skills, we are doing well with spells. So should be good. Too bad we don't have implosion, because that would have been great for a spell powered start. We do have chain lightning though, which is nice, and expert air magic, which works well with that. So we're gonna have this scenario next week, Sunday, 2 p.m. GMT onwards. Difficulty is expert. Handicap and resources, computer plays to the best of its ability, that's nice. And we can pick between one Titan, four Naga Queens, and the Altar of Wishes. Interesting choice. I think the Altar of Wishes would be a good idea, because that kind of is a long-term investment. The Titan and the Nagas can make up for it for by spell casting and stuff. So I would think we'll see. What does the map say? Now in search of the mighty Azure, you hear of disturbances to the north. Burned villages and destroyed mines are causing the region to suffer. Without the mines in full production, the region will not have the resources to defend themselves against Krulod invasion or eat. Knowing you are the distant dragon slayer, it is time to follow the road north in search of ways to hone your skills. And his stats rock, so should be good. Okay. Well, it was a lot of fun, and I was really looking forward to today. I'll be looking forward to next Sunday. Sometimes I don't know if I can hold on until next Sunday, but you know what? Maybe a little bit of expectation is better than just playing Heroes of Might and Magic 3 until I get sick of it. So we're going to see you next Sunday, next scenario. Going to have a lot of fun. Gonna see what this scenario throws at us, because Lolperlol said that we're gonna have a really hard time without Town Portal. We have Town Portal, but it still implies that there's gonna be something really difficult about this scenario. Anyway, thank you everyone for watching. This has been Rexer of the YouTube and Twitch channel Not Quite There Gaming, losing my voice and having fun. But at least I had fun, right? Fun. Yeah? Okay, good. I'm gonna find my voice now. Bye bye. Oh god, my throat is gonna be so, it's gonna hurt so much for so many days. Oh god. I always struggle how to end these videos properly, so I never know how to